What fighter out there is willing to take on the best? What fighter out there is willing to take the chance, is daring to be great? And I thought about Amir Khan instantly.
Well, I tell you one thing, you're going to see more British flags in Vegas than the Mexican flag.
Amir!
Después de la tremenda actuación que dio Saúl contra Miguel Cotto y de tapar muchas bocas, entre ellas la de Freddy Roach, de tanta gente que no creía en nosotros.
Los que cada día me levanto con esas ganas de triunfar.
¡Saúl Canelo!
Comfortable making the middleweight division and your win or lose on that fight, is that where you're going to stay?
It just depends really, because I have a huge options for me in a 147, so it just depends what I've got out there for me. But yeah, I mean, let's just see what happens. But like I said, there's a lot of rematches I can have at 147, which is a little bit more natural for me to make that weight. So it just depends on, we'll see what happens after this fight. But you know, after this fight, I mean, the rematch clause anyway. Once I beat Canelo, there's going to have to be a rematch. So in the last 6 to 8 months, my body's kind of grown. I mean, I just got big. And I don't know if that was just me just had my final growing spurt. I don't know what it is, because I really feel so strong and so big. I've been doing a lot of conditioning, and this would be an ideal fight for me, especially against someone who is, in my opinion, one of the best pound-for-pound boxers in the world.
What does Khan bring to the table that no other middleweight or super welterweight could have given you?
No, bueno, yo creo que Khan es un gran nombre, es un nombre en Inglaterra que lo quieren mucho, ¿no? Es un peleador rápido, elusivo, que tiene mucha experiencia, peleas, ha tenido grandes peleas también, entonces creo que por eso se optó por americano.
He's got a big name, you know, he's got a huge following, and he's loved in England, where he's from. But, you know, not only that, his style, you know, he's a very fast fighter, elusive, very good boxer, top level. So, you know, I think that that's a lot of qualities to make this a big event.
You're the first individual boxer that they got this endorsing to help promote the 2016 Born Bold campaign. How do you feel about that, and what do you think can do for your career?
No, bueno, creo que es historia. Es historia. Creo que soy el primer peleador que tiene un contrato con una cerveza como Tecate. Me siento orgulloso, contento de poder seguir haciendo historia también en este tipo de cosas, y contento de poder trabajar con Tecate.
It's something that's historic. It's the first fighter that they really endorse and they're behind, and you know, it's an honor for me. It's an honor. It makes me very happy. I'm excited about this project that they're going to have.
You fought Pacquiao, who's jumped up in weight and division. So what is your thoughts on this controversy between Canelo and Khan?
No, I mean, it shouldn't be a controversy. I mean, look, it's no controversy. I mean, whenever somebody tells me about a lighter guy going up in weight, I instantly think about Pacquiao and retiring me after the 9th round. I mean, I think about Sugar Ray Leonard and Marvelous Marvin Hagler, and the list goes on and on. I mean, these smaller guys coming up in weight are just guys who are courageous and who believe in themselves and who want to take the risk, and that's what makes them great.
I am very proud to present the first event under Pope Francis Foundation, Escolas Ocurrentes. This fight represents Vox Val, Boxing for Peace, a fight between a Catholic and a Muslim fighter, showing the world what sports can do, bringing people together.